So now let's talk about one potential way that we can have monopolies arise. And we're going to use the green pen because I think it's more visible. And that's the issue of natural monopoly. So natural monopoly refers to a situation where there are what we call increasing returns to scale. And increasing returns to scale mean that the more you produce, the lower your average cost. And you might think that this would always be the case, that because a larger firm would have more bargaining power or would be able to get more out of its capacity, that we'd always be able to have lower costs than a smaller firm. But it doesn't turn out to be the case. For many industries, once you reach a certain scale, then you can't reduce your per unit costs much lower. Or it may even be that as you grow larger, you actually become less cost efficient because you become bureaucratic and cumbersome and so on and so forth. In terms of a diagram, we can actually sort of draw this out. So if we're putting price here and quantity on this axis, to say that we have increasing returns to scale means that the average total cost curve is downward sloping. If it's flat, then we have what's called constant returns to scale. So size doesn't give an advantage or a disadvantage, and if it's upward sloping, then we have decreasing returns to scale. So increasing returns to scale over here, constant returns to scale in this middle region where the cost curve is flat, and decreasing returns to scale over here where the cost curve is upward sloping. So if we have increasing returns to scale, then obviously the firm that gets big first has a cost advantage over the firm that has not yet gotten big. So that perpetuates their advantage and they become bigger and bigger and bigger, and eventually they take over the entire market. Natural monopoly is actually a little bit of a tricky thing. And whether or not a monopoly is good or bad under these circumstances gets to be a hard question. And regulators face the following sort of trade-off. So let's suppose that we have some demand curve in the market. And let's suppose that the average cost curve looks like this. So if we let sort of competition go as it goes, eventually there will be no competition because eventually one firm will get large, and you can see that the sort of most efficient scale here is even bigger than the market can support. So what will happen here is if we let competition go unchecked, we'll have one monopolist. They will have low costs of production, and that's good. On the other hand, they'll be a monopolist, and they'll be able to charge a high markup over their costs, and that'll be bad. Would it be better to have a larger number of firms? Well, if we had a larger number of firms, each firm would be smaller, and each firm would have higher costs. And it might be that they charge a small markup over their costs, but it might be that small firms that are inefficient charging a small markup still leaves us worse off than a large firm charging a large markup. So that's a tricky trade-off, and there's really no easy answer as to what the best solution is. It depends upon the exact shape of these curves and so on and so forth, and it gets kind of fiddly out there. So often, though, when firms are considering merging and the Justice Department is looking and seeing whether or not that should be allowed, a key question is how much economy of scale are they going to be able to realize, and how much is the increase in their potential monopoly power going to be? So all that is our explanation of natural monopoly. To get just a little bit more exact on what natural monopoly is, the key question is, are there increasing returns to scale at the relevant scale of this market. Or more technically, is the average cost curve downward sloping where is the demand curve? So, if we have an average cost curve like this, average total cost, you can see that the most efficient scale of production is at this quantity right here. And that would give an average total cost right here. And if we sort of think about how much would consumers want to buy at that price, consumers would want to buy this amount over here. And you can see that there's room for maybe three firms of this size in this market. So this market, the scale of this market, can support three firms if cost curves are like that. So if we had a monopolist in this market, and they were trying to serve the market over here, that would be inefficient. It would be an inefficient or unnatural monopoly. On the other hand, if cost curves are like this, then it looks like the average total cost curve reaches its minimum somewhere in the neighborhood of where it hits the demand curve. That's a market that's most efficiently served by just one firm. So again, natural monopoly, the key question is, does the average cost curve have its minimum, or is it still downward sloping near where it hits the demand curve?